When I was 7 years old, I got Hot Wheels cars for the first time. My mother packed a container full of them, along with flexible tracks so I could create loops and ramps. Because in my family, building is an everyday thing. My father always took all the problems on himself, because it was his way to save money, and it was also his way to have fun. I was his wingman, learning how to do the things he does, but it was never a fun time for me. My family rarely hired a plumber or carpenter to fix our house problems, but instead, my parents always fixed it themselves. And we moved around a lot. My dad works for the government, so we have to move from place to place. And every time we bought a house, it would be a cheap fixer-upper house. And by the time it was fixed up, we would move on to the next spot. My childhood has been filled with many projects. And so my parents gave me toys, which gave me a chance to be creative, to build, and to fix, while still enjoying myself. And that was a gateway to being able to solve the same problems they do. And that's what has brought me to become an aspiring engineer and choose to build a model of the school. Throughout this project, I've learned a lot about myself, and I chose to do the model because, to be honest, I thought about what I like to do. And as I reminisced on some Lego days, which I would always want to construct something. Also, I knew about 2D versus 3D because of some engineering classes. And the three words that I always thought of all the time was 3D model, building, and Bow High School. And those three words just kind of seemed to fit together. So there I was with a rather large undertaking. What have I done, I thought. One of the challenges was that I didn't want to take a path that was already laid out for me. I want to do it a lot of the project independently. And this, I may have been a little stubborn about this part. And there was a lot of struggles with this though, like getting a job shadow. Because in a small town like Bow, you get a lot of connections by growing up here. Generations after generations after generations choose to stay here, and they make their own company, and as you grow up, you get connections with these different companies. While me, I chose to start from scratch. So I Googled up some local firms, and after emailing 8 or so places, I had 2 responses. But first come, first serve, and the slower company was thrown out, respectfully. Turns out though, Doug and I got together perfectly, and we fit perfectly also. But to my surprise, when I visited this company for the first time, that I found all by myself, there were still 2 people who were connected, friends or family, with 2 people that would go to the school. One of them was in this auditorium. When I finally started the model, the first things that I had to do was copy the school blueprints, which I basically stole for a weekend until Thursday the following week. The dimensions, or the blueprints, were stacked of around 50 pages of poster-sized paper, and they had every dimension that is needed to construct the school. And it was very confusing for me, being inexperienced, so shout out to Tom Klaproth for helping me out with that. In the final product, the blueprints turned out to be mostly useless. I drew out where all the windows, doors, nooks, and crannies of the school was into a notebook. But in the final product, I didn't use blueprints at all. The idea of using the blueprints would have required me to cut out each and every window and door, which would have been mind-blowing in a 150:1 scale. Those are some tiny windows. I quickly realized that the way I was planning on making the walls would require me to recreate the blueprints onto the foam board. Luckily though, I remembered some advice from my job shadow. Now it's to take pictures of the different designs on the school and glue them to my own walls. Thank goodness it didn't snow, because I took 100 pictures of the wall, and if it did snow, the bricks would be all different kinds of colors. I then had to scale them down from 26 feet high walls that they were down to the 2 centimeter pictures that I needed. I quickly learned that I could use the same window patterns that are on one part of the wall and apply them to another. The curved parts were challenging all on their own, but I managed to complete those parts too. I also realized that I needed to take pictures at the same eye level all around the building, but it was a challenge because the topography around the school grounds varied vastly. This new plan worked out to not only be more efficient, but also more appealing to the eye. So now that I've completed the project, what should I do with this model? I put sweat and tears and some blood on there too, because I used an X-Acto knife. Do I want to keep it though, as a representation of this wonderful community that has brought me in during my sophomore year, and also to commemorate those who embrace the outsider as one of their own? Boys. Or should I sell the school? I think I'm going to have to choose to start the bidding at $20, so anyone? $25?
Did it stop after Dalton's?
I don't know.
All I
mean, it beat my phone so bad, so no. It might still be recording then. Does it say RAC on the...
Yeah.
Yeah, never good. Never mind. We're good.
Want to just like keep it rolling in two or separate them?